previous class we already had seen the note of the poet and also had seen the brief summary of Romeo and Juliet drama. Today we'll begin the first poem, Romeo and Juliet, written by William Shakespeare. Before we could start the poem, we have to see the background which you have got in your text. Before that could be begun the poem, there is given background in your textbook in first unit. So let us see what it is given in background to know you the poem better. Background: the two noble families of Verona, the Capulets and the Montagues, were sworn enemies. In the background you have given a paragraph of the Romeo and Juliet drama's brief introduction. So here it is given, the two noble families of Verona, the Capulets and the Montagues. I want you to remember these two names because these two names will be asked for 1 mark in your annual examination. And you also have to remember the place or the name of a city which is there in Italy. Might be asked for 1 mark, might not be asked for 1 mark, but you must remember the name of the city. So here, the two noble families. I hope you know the meaning of noble. If not, know the meaning. The meaning of noble is famous or reputed, well known. So the two famous families of Verona, the families are the Capulets and the Montagues. There were two families in Verona which were very reputed. The families were the Capulets and the Montagues. And here it is given that the two noble families were, the two noble families were sworn enemies. Sworn enemies means dead enemies. Dead enemies means in Kannada ajata shatrugalu anta heltivi naavu. Well, sworn enemies, which means dead enemies. Andre kannadadalli baddha vairigalu anta heltivi naavu. Oppanu kandre innobbarige aagta irodilla anta vairigalige we call as sworn enemies. So they lived two families in Verona. The name of the families are the Capulets and the Montagues, and both the families were sworn enemies. Now let us see what it is given in next lines. Romeo and Juliet belonged to rival families. Romeo and Juliet. belonged to which families? Rival families. The meaning of rival is enemy. So here, Romeo and Juliet belonged to enemy families. Old Lord Capulet, I want you to note this word. Old Lord Capulet hosted a grand supper. In next line, it is given that Old Lord Capulet hosted. The meaning of hosted is organized. So, Old Lord Capulet organized a grand supper. The meaning of supper is dinner. So, Old Lord Capulet organized a grand dinner party. Though Romeo belonged to the family of Montagues, through this line, you will get clear with the family of whose? Romeo's. Romeo belonged to which family? Montague's family. It is understood that Juliet belonged to which family? The Capulets family. In next line, that also it is given. We'll see that information through the next lines. So, yeah, though Romeo belonged to the family of Montagues, he attended the supper in disguise. He attended the supper in disguise. The meaning of disguise. The maker to hide the maker to hide one's identity. The meaning of disguise is the makeup to hide one's identity. Andre, nanna nanu nanu anta gurtiskolbardu annodakke makeup maadkotinalla, that is called as disguise. So here it is given, Romeo attended the supper in disguise, making up himself not to be identified. He as Romeo to see Rosaline. The pronunciation of R-O-S-E-L-I-N-E is not rose line. Pronunciation of this word is Rosaline. Rosaline is dream girl of or dream lady of Romeo. Rosaline is the name of dream lady of Romeo's. Even though Romeo belonged to the family of Montagues, he attended the supper in disguise to see whom the dream lady of his, whose name is Rosaline, whom he yearned a lot, whom he admired a lot. To convey his love to Rosaline, by the assistance of his friends, he decides to go to the supper which is hosted by the old Lord Capulet. So in next lines, let us see what happens. There he sees Juliet on the dance floor. Actually, Romeo had gone to the supper to see Rosaline. But when he enters the Capulet's family, he suddenly sees the beautiful lady whose name is Juliet. There he sees Juliet on the dance floor and is fascinated by her beauty. The meaning of fascinate is attracted. Actually, Romeo had gone to the supper to see Rosaline, and when he sees Juliet, he forgot Rosaline and got attracted by the beauty of the beautiful young lady called Juliet. After the dance, he learns. Here, the meaning of learns is not learning something, but knows. So when the measure done, Romeo learns or knows that she is Juliet. Juliet is the daughter of Lord Capulet. After the dance, Romeo comes to know that Juliet belongs to the Capulet's family, who is the daughter of old Lord Capulet, who hosted the supper. In the second line, it is given that Capulet's family and Montague's family were sworn enemies. It means when the dance got over, Romeo knew that Juliet belongs to the rival family. Let us see next time what it is given. She feels attracted to the man from the enemy family. Even Juliet feels attracted or fascinated to the man from the enemy family. It means Romeo belonged to Montague's family. The Montague's family and the Capulet's family both knew that they were sworn enemies to each of the families. Even though Juliet knew that Romeo belonged to the Montague's family, rival family, she also got attracted by the man Romeo. The following verses express their implicit feelings for one another. The following verses, the meaning of verses is small poems which you have got in your text of Romeo's and Juliet, which the title is Romeo and Juliet. So, the following small poems of Romeo's and Juliet express their implicit, they which Romeo's and Juliet's implicit. The meaning of implicit is unseen. Their unseen feelings for one another. The following Romeo and Juliet verses express the unseen emotional feelings of Romeo towards Juliet and Juliet towards Romeo. To see their implicit feelings, we have to begin the verses of Romeo's and Juliet's. Let us begin the verse of Romeo's.
The verse of Romeo's is a monologue. The verse of Romeo's is a monologue. The meaning of monologue is the feelings of oneself or the thoughts of oneself which he or she expresses to the audience. So Romeo's verse is a monologue. Before we could see the lines of Romeo's monologue, it is very important for us to know the thing which is given here in the bracket after the lines of Romeo's monologue. In the bracket, here it is given Act 1, Scene 5. You might surprise to see what here in the bracket might be given. So I want you to clear that. Already we have discussed that the Romeo and Juliet poem is an extracted verse from Romeo and Juliet drama. And this verse of Romeo's is extracted from first act of the drama, from fifth scene. This verse is extracted from Romeo and Juliet drama of William Shakespeare's, and this is extracted from first act of fifth scene. In Romeo and Juliet drama, we have total five acts. In five acts, from first act, from fifth scene, this small poem or verse of Romeo is extracted. Now, with that information, let us see the beautiful monologue of Romeo's. Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. See the beautiful words used by the poet. Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. She here refers to Juliet. The monologue means Romeo is expressing his feelings or thoughts to the audience. He exclaims with joy. He exclaims with joy that Juliet teaches the torches to burn bright, which means he finds Juliet's beauty so beautiful that he says she's so bright and beautiful that she is able to teach even the torches to burn more bright. See the sentence, how beautiful it is. She's so beautiful, he says, she's so beautiful that she can teach the torches to burn bright, which means the beauty of Juliet's surpasses. The beauty of Juliet's surpasses the brightness of the torches. Usually, we the people use the torches to burn bright in the darkness. So he says that Juliet is so beautiful that her beauty surpasses the brightness of the torches. He says she could teach the torches to burn bright. That much brightness Romeo he sees in Juliet when she was dancing on the dance floor. It seems she hangs upon the cheek of a knight as a rich jewel in an Ethiop's ear. In these two lines, Romeo uses simile, figure of speech,
the simile figure of speech in the given verse. So in these two lines, Romeo uses simile figure of speech to express Juliet's beauty. He says, it seems she hangs upon the cheek of a knight as a rich jewel in an Ethiop's ear. I hope you remember the meaning of an Ethiop. In our previous class, when we were learning the glossary words, there we had learned the meaning of Ethiop, which means an African. He says, it seems she hangs upon the cheek of a knight as a rich jewel in an Ethiop's ear. When Juliet was dancing on the dance floor, he feels Juliet so beautiful. Actually, he had been there at night because he went to meet Rosaline, who was about to visit the supper of old Lord Capulet. So, in the night on the dance floor, Juliet was dancing and Romeo got fascinated by her beauty and says, it seems she hangs upon the cheek of a knight. To the knight, he compares as a face, and to the face there will be seen a cheek, and he says, it looks, Juliet is hanging, Juliet is swinging on the cheek of a knight. Means she was sparkling on a dance floor with her beautiful attire and with her beautiful beauty. So he says, it seems she hangs upon a cheek of a knight. Knight is compared to the face, and face will be having a cheek, and on the cheek of a knight who was hanging, he says, Juliet was hanging. He says, that much beautifully she was stepping herself on the dance floor, was swinging from one place to another place. It looked just like she was hanging to the cheek of a knight, which he compares to the rich jewel of an Ethiop's ear. An Ethiop is an African. An African means the dark person. The way how the rich jewel, like diamond or ornament, shines in dark person's ear, the same way, the way how the diamond ornament shines, sparkles in dark person's ear, the same way, Romeo says, Juliet was hanging upon the cheek of the knight. Let us see next time what he says about Juliet. Beauty too rich for use, for earth too dear. The meaning of too dear is too expensive. Too expensive. It says beauty too rich for use, for earth too dear. He finds Juliet's beauty so beautiful that he says her beauty is very, very, very rich, which cannot be used. Even though the earth is too dear, he says, even though the earth is too dear, the earth depreciates its value before the beauty of Juliet. We all believe that the earth is very expensive because all the creatures are living on the earth, and the earth bears everyone on its bosom. If there is no earth, there is no life of ours. That much expensive the earth is. But according to Romeo, the beauty of Juliet is so rich that the expensiveness of earth is depreciated before her beauty. So here he says beauty too rich for use, for earth too dear. Even though the earth is expensive, very valuable, it is depreciated before the beauty of Juliet. That much rich her beauty is, he feels. Now let us see in next line what he emphasizes. So shows a snowy town drooping with crows as yonder lady over her fellows shows. Contrast imagery is being used by the writer here. Contrast imagery means opposite color or opposite taste is being compared to give value for one. So here Romeo uses contrast imagery as well as simile figure of speech. He uses contrast imagery as well as simile figure of speech. I already have told you, simile is very important, will be asked for 4 marks in your examination. So here he even uses simile figure of speech. He says, so shows a snowy dove. You all know the meaning of snowy dove, white color. Duck is called as what? White color duck is called as snowy duck. Trooping, meaning of trooping is marching. Marching, walking. Meaning of marching is walking. With crows. You all know the meaning of what? Crows. Crows. Kannada dalli naavu adakke anta helthivi.
gentle lady over her fellows' shores. The meaning of fellows? Friends? Already we have learned the meaning of yonder in our previous class. I hope you might have forgotten. I am there to remember you. The meaning of yonder is over there. Over there. ಅದನ್ನ ನಾನು ಗ್ಲೋಸರಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತಾನು ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆ. ಸೊ ಯಾ ಸೊ ಶೋಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ನೋ ವೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೂಪಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಯಾಂಡರ್ ಲೇಡಿ ಓವರ್ ಹರ್ ಫೆಲೋಸ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಹೌ ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್ಡ್ ಡಕ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಶೋಸ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಹೌ ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್ಡ್ ಡಕ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ when it marches or walks with crows. See contrast imagery. Crow is black and snowy dove is white. To give importance for snowy dove. To give importance for snowy dove. Here, the writer used crows. This is called as contrast imagery. The way how white-colored duck or doe looks when it walks with many dark-colored birds or crows. The same way, yonder, over there means here, on the dance floor, where Juliet was dancing. On the dance floor, where Juliet was dancing. On the dance floor, lady refers to Juliet. On the dance floor, Juliet was looking with her friends. The way how white-colored bird was looking completely different among the crows when it was marching or trooping, the same way Juliet looked on the dance floor when she was dancing with her friends. Juliet is compared to the snowy dove and her fellows are compared to the crows. This is how Romeo sees the beauty of Juliet. Let us see next line what he wants to say. The measure done, I will watch her place of stand. Already we have learned the meaning of measure done in our previous class in glossary. The meaning of measure done is dance ended. So now Romeo, who was watching the dance of Juliet, says that the measure done says that after the dance ended, I will watch her place of stand. He watches her place of dance. He
to wait the dance of horse to be stopped. Actually, there on the dance floor, Juliet was dancing with her fiancé, whose name was Paris. He was dancing with her fiancé. When she was dancing with her fiancé, Romeo sees her beauty and caught hold of her beauty and says to himself that he would wait for her to be stopped. So he says he would wait her to be ended her dance. So the measure done, I will watch her place of stand. When the dance will get over, he wants her steps to be stopped. Stopped. In next line, he says, and touching hers, Meg blessed my rude hand. Next line he says, touching hers, Meg blessed my rude hand. When her dance with Paris, who was her fiancé, would get over, he wanted to offer Juliet to be danced with him. When he would have offered, Juliet would have touched, him. And he found Juliet so beautiful that he found angel in her. And tells to himself that if she touches him, he would be blessed. His rude hand would get what? Blessed. Pure. He calls his hand as rude hand because he was not the son of an ordinary family, but was a son of noble family called Montagues. Means was a prince. Romeo was not an ordinary man, but was the prince of. I hope you know what prince is. Raja Kumara, and healthy now. He was the prince of Montague's family and had waged many wars. Sakashtu yuddhagalannu avanu enu madida? Already madida. And in the war, he had killed many opposite people. Tanna eduraligalannu sakashtu mandina avanu enu madida? Had killed. The killing of people had made his hand rude, he says. So he says that if he touches Juliet, his rude hand becomes what? Blessed. So he says when the dance gets over, he must offer a dance with Juliet. When Juliet touches him, it would be the touch of angels and his rude hand would become the blessed one. Let us see next line. What he wants to say. Did my heart love till now? Now, Romeo and Juliet are dancing on the dance floor. When he sees the beauty of Juliet's very close. So attracted by the beauty of Juliet's that he frames a question to him, and the question was whether his heart loved anyone else till then. Very beautiful question, whether his heart had yearned anybody else before he could see Juliet. You know the answer? Because he had come to Lord Capulet's supper to see whom? Rosalie. Means he already had yearned somebody, admired somebody. But now when he sees Juliet, he feels that the Rosaline's love was not love, it was only the admiration. Adu vandu avanada bayake agittu but adu preeti agirilla annodakke he asks a question whether his heart had loved anybody else before he could see. He only gives the answer. Let us see what he says. Forswear it sight. Forswear it sight. For I never saw true beauty till this night. Now he takes oath on his sight. Forswear it sight. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅವನ ದೃಷ್ಟಿಯ ಮೇಲೆ ಅವನೇ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿಜ್ಞೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಆಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತಾನೆ. ಸ್ವೇ ಆಣೆ, ಪ್ರತಿಜ್ಞೆ, ಓತ್ ರಿಕಾಲ್, ಪ್ರಾಮಿಸ್ ರಿಕಾಲ್. ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೈಟ್ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್, ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಮಿಸ್ ಆನ್ ಮೈ ಸೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ನೆವರ್ ಸಾ ಟ್ರೂ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ನೈಟ್. ಸೇಸ್ till that night in which he had seen Juliet on the dance floor, he had never seen a true beauty. That much beauty, that beautiful young lady he had got in him, says Romeo through his monologue. So that he say love is blind. These words are of Romeo's, which means he sees Juliet that much beautiful, but the other person might not see that much beauty in Juliet. But Romeo found that much beauty in Juliet and forgot Rosaline. Forgot Rosaline and had fallen in love with Juliet. So this is the verse of Romeo. Let us see the verse of Juliet.